About 3 years ago, I did a video on a DIY drip coffee maker using the top of a Gatorade bottle to make a drip coffee maker. You put a coffee filter in here. I got a little stick, piece of bamboo. It goes through here and it sits on the top of your coffee cup. You make coffee or thermos. I use my thermos in case, so I make a whole thermos one time. The problem is that for some reason or other, in the last year or so, I've had to make a couple of these and had come to realize, I don't know if it's something new or whether it was like that in the past and I never noticed it, but the plastic is like heat shrinkable plastic now. If you put too much heat to it, it changes shape, tries to revert back to its original size. It's like expanded plastic. I even had a 32 ounce Gatorade coffee maker that I put boiling water in, and that thing shrank down to the size of a regular 20 ounce bottle. This one I just used a couple of weeks ago, and it's gotten all deformed just from the heat trying to make water or coffee. So I'm going to go with an aluminum bottle. I bought this bottle of Mountain Dew. I'm not really a big Mountain Dew drinker, but the bottle's going to work, I think. It's big enough that it'll fit over my stoves inside the pot. And I'm going to start just by cutting the bottle top off and inverting it and using it as a funnel, just like the plastic one. Only this one will be metal and I won't have to worry about it changing shape or size. So that's where I'm at for this project. New drip coffee maker. Needs to be tall enough to hold a fair amount of coffee, but short enough to fit inside my cook pot. When it's nested over my stove. Like that. Let's see. I'll take the windscreen stuff out. That is slightly too tall. That's why I cut it a little long. See, I got two lines here. I cut it off at that line. I may have to recut it at this line. Either that or maybe I can fold it over to that line and reinforce this top some. It's a little flimsy. Let me think about it a minute. Okay, here's what I'm going to try. Like I said, I did leave this extra. Wow, it's really dark. I did leave this extra about a quarter inch there, 3/8 inch at the top to cut it down further if I needed to cut it down. But you know, I've been experimenting here and I think I'm going to fold it. This is the other half of the can, and maybe you can see I just folded the edge over. It gives it some rigidity, and it's actually a double fold. What I did was took a scrap piece of wood, cut a slot in it, and then the slot acts as a depth gauge. Fits down over the edge of the can, and then I just bent it down all the way around, folded it over. Smooth that out and then bend it, folded it over again for the second time so it's double ridged. It's been double folded, excuse me. Actually folded twice here. So that's what I'm going to do tomorrow. I'm going to stop now. It's midnight. So this is going to be my bend gauge. As I was showing last night, I did practice on the other edge of the on the other end of the can And it comes out with a fairly decent fold. So I'm just going to put it on the edge of the can. Put it down here in the library, see. On the edge of the can and fold it over. Just get as close to the previous fold as you can. And that's about it for this rim. Looks pretty ragged, doesn't it? But those will all fold over. Just going to use my fingers here. Roll it down. Okay, that's the initial roll. And I'm going to smooth that out on a wood block that I've rounded the edges on. Actually, I've used this wood block for several things. It's come in pretty handy. Let me move the camera. You can see it's got a rounded edge here, so I'm just going to put the can on here and tap it around. Okay, it's down all nice and flat. So I'm going to fold it again using my little folding tool. Just put it on the can down to the slot and bend it over. Come back. If you can't get on the can right where the fold is, then do your best to get on there and come back as close to the previous fold as you can. Okay, there's the second fold. Again, doesn't look very good, but once you work on it a little bit, it should turn out fine, like the other one did. Let's hope anyway. I think we're about finished with this stage. Let's see how it came out with the other one. Okay, there, pretty close. Okay, so there's the edge. Nice, flat, double rolled edge. Actually, I guess it's a double folded edge, not a double rolled edge. But now I don't have any sharp edge here, and it gives me some support for the top, so it's not just a flimsy single edge top. And I need to drill my holes yet, straight across here for my support stick, like this one was. And then I'll need a hole in the bottom of the cap for the drip. Let's do 7/16. The idea of that folded lip. I'd rather not actually be through that, but just under it. Okay, so the holes came out below my edge. I'll smooth those down some. 3/16. Okay, let's smooth out the edges and it is done. Okay, so to use this, we're going to take a number 4 cone coffee filter, shove it down inside, fold the edge over, take this bamboo skewer stick that I cut to length and stick it through the filter and the holes we've made in the drip maker. And the reason for doing this is to keep the filter from collapsing and falling inside. Originally I did it without putting the stick through the filters, and the water causes the filter to just kind of collapse and fall inside itself. Then the stick will allow the maker to just hang on the edge of a coffee cup like that. Put your grounds in here and pour your hot water in, make a cup of coffee. Or do like I do, make it a little extra strong. This fits on top of the thermos without even needing a stick, but or without hanging, I usually make an extra strong half thermos of coffee and then take the coffee maker off and fill up the rest of the thermos with boiling water. So that comes out about the right strength and it makes it really good and hot. So it'll keep all day into the night if I'm doing that. Or like I said, make a single cup with just your drip maker. Works well. I've been doing it this way for 3 years now. And you might say, well, there are instant coffees out there. Yeah, but like I said in my original video, I can buy a whole, well, I guess it's not a pound anymore. It used to be a pound bag. 12-ounce bag of coffee, ground coffee that I can use at home too, for less than the cost of 8 of those instant coffee packs. Now this works out a lot more economical. And let's double check here. Get my pot, coffee maker, stove, inside the pot, windscreen. Skewer, can make that on the scene with just a piece of stick. My folding spoon, lighter, and a cleanup towel. And aluminum, this is just a little aluminum square that I put underneath the stove so it doesn't burn the top of anything you set it on. Put this in there. Lid fits right on top, and the whole thing fits inside my storage bag. This pot, by the way, is a 32-ounce aluminum pot from batchstoves.com. It's a nice little pot. It comes with or without the bale handle, and nice little made-to-fit lid. Sam makes these custom-made, so he makes them all. They're not something that he purchases and resells. He makes every one of these, and boy, he's made it real nice, too. Got a nice rolled edge there. It's a nice pot. It's anodized, so it's hard. It'll take some wear. Okay, that's the setup for now. All that for drip coffee. So, but in the early mornings, it's worth it.